So welcome to Glädjehuset, Meat Loaf. You used a lot of energy there, didn't you?
Oh, yeah, I think I'll faint for you.
But is it true, though, that you sometimes faint on stage?
Yeah, I do, I do. I don't really faint, but I do fall down. Not on the stage, after.
Your show's been described as sometimes tasteless and revolting. Is that something you're working on?
Yeah, it's the same as Mahler. In 1812, Mahler did his Ninth Symphony in Paris, and they said it was loud, tasteless, a few other adjectives in that way, and people were walking out. Now, Mahler has gone on to become something that I'll never be, but the review was the same.
I understand.
I would like to be Mahler. Mahler frightens people in his symphonies. The Ninth Symphony, people are there, you see. And at the end, they're off on a thing, and they hit this big anvil. And people
which,
scream. Are you trying to get past me here?
Yeah. Go ahead. Which brings us to your acting, because you're not only a singer, you're actually an actor as well.
Yeah, I've done. I'll settle down for you now. I've done Rodrigo and Othello, Shakespeare. Done Amiens and As You Like It. I've done 6 movies. Done a lot of off-Broadway stuff. I've worked with Al Pacino, Meryl Streep, Charles Durning,
So when you perform, it's actually kind of mixture between singing.
Yeah, I think you know, I think that the acting thing I did really put a whole nother level to everything for me. I mean, I noticed the lights and I noticed what those people did, and it really helps because rock and roll is an entertainment, and so is you know, theater. Yeah. So, you know, you just combine the two and sort of take it out, because most kids won't go to the theater because it's boring. Mm. A lot of it is, and I can understand that, because a lot of it bores me.
Now, is this what you're going to continue doing? Okay.